Philippine shares joined other Asian markets fluctuate on Tuesday on surging COVID infections, new lockdowns, and brewing political turmoil in the U.S. The PSE index shed more than half of 1% to close at 72.58, with decliners beating advancers 144 to 86. Net foreign selling also resumed. Despite Tuesday's slide, analysts remain optimistic long-term.
The market has a better grasp of the possible recovery. The market participants have actually revised their expected earnings for the next 12 months, and they are now expecting earnings to grow around 24%, no? Which somehow tamed the overvaluation which we saw in the forward PE last December. If we are operating under the theme of recovery, no? Basically what we are looking at are the cyclical sectors, no? And again, as highlighted, no, by First Metrotech Research, definitely the property sector should be a beneficiary of a strong recovery moving forward.
Meanwhile, GlobalLink Securities says market fundamentals remain sound, with investor interest surprisingly in high-value liquid stocks, more than blue chips. In corporate stories, Visman developer Cebu Land Masters reports a record 14.25 billion pesos in reservation sales for 2020, up 12.4%, defying challenges faced by the industry during the pandemic. 69% of last year's sales are for its economic brand, Casa Mira, 19% for its mid-market garden series, and 10% for its Premier Masters. The company launched 9 new projects last year, worth collectively around 11.4 billion pesos. Meanwhile, Asia United Bank, the Robisco Group's banking unit, will redeem earlier 5 billion pesos worth of Tier 2 notes due 2025 this February. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.